Now see that question number 7. Find the largest 3-digit number which is a perfect square. First of all, what you will do? First, you will write the largest 3-digit number. Largest 3-digit number. Everybody of you already know what can be the and what is largest 3-digit number. That is always 999. Now you have to, but this 999 is not a perfect square. We have to find the largest 3-digit number which will be a perfect square. What we will do? Just see here on the board now. Write 999, start making pairing from that side, okay? And here only this 9 is remain on the left side. So what you will do? Find the square number which will be nearer to 9. So 3 is a 9, okay? Then nothing will left. Bring down now 99 plus 3. It will be 3 plus 3, 6. Now we have to select a square number which will be very nearer to 99. If I will select 1, so it will come 61. Okay. If I will select 2 into 2 to the 4 and 2 6 to 12, it will be greater than 99. So we cannot select 2. So which number we will select? 1 we can select. Okay. So see that you will write 1 here and 1 also here. 1 ja 1 and 1 6 ja 6. So 9 minus 1, 8. 9 minus 6, 3. Okay. And you were having number, greatest number is 3 digit number, you were having 999. 999 minus 38. Okay. So 9 minus 8, 1. 9 minus 3, 6. And this will be 961. So 961 will be the greatest 3 digit number which will be a perfect square. And for what can be the square root of this number? Obviously 31. Have you understood or not? In this way you can make many questions for you. Find the largest 3-digit I have done. You can write largest 4-digit number which can be a perfect square. Largest 5-digit number which can be a perfect square. In this way you can form question for you and you can find the answers of those ones. What I have done, just try to understand. We were having number 999 and I have tried to find the square root of this number and whatever that now after remainder there because we are not having the another set of numbers, so further division is not possible. So whatever remainder is there, you just subtract that remainder from the greatest number. In this way whatever number will come, that will be your answer. Okay, now come to the next question, that is question number 8. In question number 8, he is saying us that find the number of digit in the square root of the following number. Okay, he is not saying us to find the square root of these numbers. He is just asking how many digit will come if we will find the square root of these numbers. You already know if we will 64 is the square of 8, so how many digit are in square root of 64? One digit. Okay. Is equal to, that is A. No, for A part. 225. You already know 225 is the square root of 15. And you also know that while we were finding the square root at that time, what we were doing? We were making the pairing from right hand side. Okay. And for this 2, okay, one digit will come. And then we will bring down this pair. So one more digit will come. Then how many digit will be here in the square root of 225? 2 digits. Okay. So by the observation we can find that how many digits will be in the square root of the given number. So in 225 it will be 2 digits in B part. Just try to understand one more part, that is C part, and then rest of the 2 part you will perform yourself. Okay. I am doing D part, not C part. C part you will do yourself. Okay. 17161. 17161. Just start pairing from here. Okay. So one digit will come for this. In this way you can find. One digit will come for this. And वन डिजिट विल कम फॉर दैट अलोन पार्ट. सो हाउ मेनी डिजिट शुड बी देयर? सी दैट वन डिजिट प्लस वन डिजिट प्लस वन डिजिट, हाउ मेनी डिजिट इट विल बी? थ्री डिजिट्स. ओके, इन दिस वे यू कैन नाउ मे बी एवरीबडी ऑफ यू हैव अंडरस्टूड हाउ वी आर फाइंडिंग. वी आर नॉट, वी विल नॉट फाइंड द स्क्वायर रूट इन दिस गिवन क्वेश्चन. Only the number of digit we have to say that how many digits will be in the, if we will find the square root of this given number. One more part I am doing, let's see that. That is E part. 50625. You can do this question for the previous question, means question number one also you can and then you can find match it with your answer. In this way you will be very clear in your concept. Now start making pair. One digit will come for this one. Okay, for this we will find one digit. Okay, for this pairing another pair we will find one digit. Okay, and one digit we will find for this alone part. Okay, one digit. Now how many digits will be there? One digit plus one digit plus one digit. How many digit number will come? Three digit number. Okay. How many digits will come? Three digits. Okay. In this way, one part I left for you that you will complete that part yourself. Now come to the question number nine. The side of a square field is 73 meter. What is the area of this field? I am not doing this question number nine. You can do this. Everybody of you already know what is the formula for area of square. This is the very means earlier classes you have done this. So area of square is equal to side into side, and whatever the length of the square you have to given, you will find the area of that square. Okay, now see that question number 10, and that is the last question of this exercise now, or this chapter also. Okay, a right angle triangle has side 12 meter and 5 meter. Okay, right angle triangle have side 12 meter and 5 meter. Okay, what is the length of hypotenuse? What is the length of hypotenuse? You already know just now in question number 6 I have done this. So you will find hypotenuse square is equal to P square plus B square. You everybody knows in previous class we had done lot of questions on this formula. So question number 10 is also your homework. I am not doing this one also. Okay, now one last pattern question are also given. Those questions are not in your exercise, but those questions are comes in your there, because the question that those which are given in your example part, those types of question comes here in exam. So I am just going to tell you, and these kinds of questions are given on your page number in the beginning, that is on page number 24. You can see that, and I am going to tell you how you will find the problems like that. Okay, we have question on your page number 24. You can see it from there. That is example in your book, but these patterns of questions are very important for your learning part. Just see that, find the square of the following number without multiplication. We have given 52. Okay, and he is not asking that you will how you can find its square. Simply what you are doing, 52 multiplied by 52. He is saying you that not by multiplication you have to find the square of this number. Then what is the another way by which way we can find the square of this number? Just see here. We have one formula. Okay, I am writing here formulas. You will write those formulas in your copies. Okay, A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. How it comes? If we will multiply the bracket A plus B into A plus B. Okay, A plus B into A plus B. Then this result will come. See that how it will come. If I will multiply this into this, A plus B, and then this B plus B or A plus B. See that A into A, A square, A into B plus AB, plus B into A, AB we can write, or plus B square. see that now. A square. AB and AB. How many AB? 2AB. A plus B square. Okay. In this way it comes. And one more identity is for that. A minus B whole square. And it is just same result will be there. And only minus sign will come here in the middle term. A square minus 2AB or plus B square. So you will remember these two identities. These are very important for you for this solving these kinds of problem. I am solving two problems based on these two identities. Just see. We have to find 52 square. How we can find 52 square? We will write 52 in the form of A plus B. I can write it simply 50 plus 2. Okay. And we have to find the square. If you will find the square means 52 square. Okay. Means 50 plus 2 whole square we can write it. Okay. Then apply the identity here. 50 plus 2. 50 consider 50 as A and 2 as B. Okay. Now what you will write? A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB or plus B square. Here in place of A what you have? A is equal to 50 and B is equal to 2. Now put these values here in your formula. A means 50 square. Many students, many children are writing like that. This is wrong way. Better is that in what pattern you should write? In this way. 50 square plus 2. A means 50 or B means 2. A B square means 2 square. Now see that simplified. 50 square means 5 to 25. Or 0, 2 times 0 will come. Plus 50 to the 100. 100 to the 200. Or plus 2 to the 4. So what it will be? 25, 100 plus 200, 2704. It will be your answer. In this way, you can find 50 plus 2 whole square. Next question is that, next I am writing you, which means on the same way, which part you will solve, that will be your homework. 67 square, how you can write it? You will write it 60 plus 7 whole square and same as I have done, you will solve it. And then another part also I am writing you 102 square. How you will write it? Always if you will have 102 and 105 or 107, how you will write them? You will write this question as 100 plus 2 whole square. And same way by applying the formula you will solve them. So these two are your homework. You will perform them and send me as your homework. Okay. Now one question based on minus that also we are going to solve and then in this way then our this chapter will be completed. Now see that 98 square we have to find. Minus based question are not given in your book, but I am teaching you so that you may understand the concept also, because same thing is there, nothing is is both or both the types of questions are very similar, so there is no problem. 98 always we will not try to write always in the form of 100. Okay, so don't write it 90 plus 8. It will be very critical for you. How you will write it? 100 minus 2 whole square. Okay, now apply this identity. A minus B whole square is equal to A square minus 2AB or plus B square. See that now. A minus B means we are finding 100 minus 2 whole square. Okay. So, in place of A, you have 100 or in place of B, you have, if we will compare them, then in place of B, you will get 2 or in place of A, you will get 100. So, put the values here. A means 100 square. Okay. Minus 2AB. 2 into 100 or into 2. A plus B square means 2 square. Simply, nothing is there. Okay. 100 square means if we will have 2 zeros, I taught to you before. Then it will become 4 times 0 if we will do the square of these numbers. So what it will be? 1 0 0 0 0 minus 2 to the 4, 400. Okay, a plus 2 to the 4. See, now subtract it. If 10,000 minus 400, how it will be? 9,600. okay, n plus 4. So what will be your answer? 9600. Just simple. In this way, you will find the square, 97 square. You will find yourself. And how you will write it? 100 minus 3 whole square. And then in the same way, you will apply your identity. Okay, just in this way, this chapter has completed. And you just revise it more and more time. Don't think that you are very, those children are sending me their homework. Most of the things they are doing correctly. But do regular practice so that you cannot forget the chapter.